The Mandela Effect. The science behind our collective false memories. Did you ever start watching a movie on TV with your friends and see an actor or actress who you and your friends remember as having died? Then a quick Google search assures you that they're very much alive. This common occurrence is called the Mandela Effect, and it is a collective misremembering of a fact or event. The term Mandela Effect was first coined by the paranormal enthusiast Fiona Broom, who along with people from all over the world remembered former South African President Nelson Mandela as having died in prison during the 1980s. People even remembered watching Mandela's funeral on TV during the 1980s. In fact, after 27 years in prison, Nelson Mandela was released, went on to become South Africa's president, and didn't die until 2013. A similar example of the Mandela Effect is the canonization of Mother Teresa. People from different countries have a distinct memory of seeing Mother Teresa being canonized during her lifetime, sometime in 1990s, by Pope Paul II. In reality, her canonization didn't occur until September 4, 2016, 19 years after her death. On June 5, 1989, during the Tiananmen Square protest in China, many people remember seeing the lone man who stood in front of the tanks rolling into the square be run over and killed. In actuality, that never happened. Many people remember the color chartreuse as being a reddish purple or magenta color. Chartreuse is actually a yellowish green color. People remember the band Queen's song, We Are the Champions, as ending with no time for losers, because we are the champions of the world. But its final lyric actually is, no time for losers, because we are the champions. In the popular Star Wars film, The Empire Strikes Back, most of us would swear that Darth Vader told Luke Skywalker, Luke, I am your father. In reality, Vader said, no, I am your father. Even the famous phrase from Walt Disney's Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs isn't safe from misremembering. The evil queen never said, mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all? She actually said, magic mirror on the wall. What is causing this collective misremembering? Modern psychological theory holds that memory is constructive, not reproductive. That means our brains build memories on the fly, out of pieces of information, as opposed to playing memories back like a recording. Because of that, our memories can be distorted by bias, association, imagination, or even peer pressure. A possible quantum explanation for the Mandela Effect was put forth by physicist Fred Allen Wolf. He defined a difference between the reality in our dreams and the reality during our waking hours. Wolf describes quantum physics as being made up of probabilities, and out of those probabilities, actualities manifest. Wolf maintains that the collective unconscious manifests in our dreams and reflects what the entire planet as a whole is experiencing. Sometimes the Mandela Effect is so strong that it overtakes reality. People remember a character from the movie Gremlins as being named Spike. In actuality, the character was named Stripe. But bending to the Mandela Effect, in November 2016, a t-shirt featuring the character Spike was released for sale.